Chuck and Bell.
Machine. There's a wormhole inside there. When I get in there with that bottle of Crown, oh no, I'm sorry.
That's a different wormhole.
Tell them about the After Dark punk junkie. That's the stuff people want to hear.
What's that?
After Dark.
You talk about the times after we're done?
Yeah.
The ones that you don't remember.
When the event shuts down, everybody stays. A lot of people are out there camping, and so they just like start barbecuing and partying.
Well, it actually starts on Friday morning at 7 o'clock when we open the gates.
There you go, 7 in the morning.
7 o'clock in the morning, the gates open. There's already a 5-mile line out there waiting to get into this event. And it goes nonstop until Sunday night about 7 o'clock when we shut it down. So if you want to go to a 3-day party that's probably comparable to Comic-Con, come to Delaware, because I'll tell you what, it'll be a different way. But we're in 1,000-acre cornfield, there's no traffic, and you can have a great time down there with us.
Well, and on that note, if you have never seen Pumpkin Chucking, shame on you. And now you're going to get a chance to preview it. With the next one.
We're in Delaware.
We got pumpkins.
I only need one thing.
It's Pumpkin Chucking time!
Engineering have gathered again. Their obsession, hurling cords into the heavens. Armed with the descendants of ancient weapons of war. The victor will bask in eternal Pumpkin Chucking glory. Embrace the sting of defeat. Will this reigning queen defend her throne? Is this the day a dreamer topples a dynasty? And will this man redefine the world athlete?
Fun at all. So, very boring. So, you know,
I was going to ask Frank, did you guys just wake up one morning and say, I want to see how far I can grow a pumpkin and how far I can grow?
Do you want your story?
Yes, I do.
Okay, honest story. There were four men sitting in a blacksmith shop in Lewis, Delaware, and they were discussing medieval games, primarily anvil tossing, and they found very quickly, being old guys, that it was tough on their back. And then they heard some kids in Salisbury, Maryland were throwing pumpkins by hand to raise funds for some event. Being good Sussex Countyans, they said, we can build machines to do that. They did. They threw down the proverbial gauntlet, which happened to be the blacksmith's hat. They all stomped on it and said they'd meet the first Saturday in November. That was in 1986, and we've been going strong ever since. We had three machines, approximately 87 people. First toss, the winning toss that year was 114 feet. And to put that in perspective, last year, or in 2010, because last year we got sanctified, and in 2011, we probably saw 125,000 people, 115 machines, and we have machines whose barrels extend over 120 feet. So you can roll it out the end. But we're throwing pumpkins, 10-pound pumpkins, almost a mile.
Is escape velocity the goal? Like, when
we stop? I swear, when we reach that mythical mile, if we've got to set a new goal. Like a mile and a half.
Well, all right, well, so the Mythbusters crew has been in all this for a little while now, and I think we should take a look at the next clip, which features one of them.
You're afraid you're going to overshort?
Impossible. Impossible to overtort.
Now, the machine might break, but that's okay. That means we've shot it, you know?
Before any team fires, they must know the three most important rules of pumpkin chunking. Each machine gets three chunks, one per round. The pumpkin must weigh between 8 and 10 pounds and must remain intact until it hits the ground. Otherwise, it's known as pumpkin pie.
They're about to go for the shot. Oh my gosh! Wow! Wow!
thought we were done.
Bob's new Hickory arm tosses a monster shot of 1,916 feet. He sets the bar high.
Here and here, torsion rules.
Into it. I mean, that guy is a correctional facility counselor helping prisoners, but then he dresses up like a knight and goes and flings pumpkins during the day. I mean, it's just, it was so, being next to these torsion machines, it's I'm not gonna lie, it's completely terrifying. Because there's so much energy as they're, you know, cranking those arms back and the ropes are tensioning up, and if anything breaks, it's like, you got splinters flying everywhere. Now, Mythbusters, we're usually behind shields, you know, in bunkers, but we're like right next to these giant machines. It's nuts.
And it sounds like there's even more, like,
and
you guys possibly that on.
They tend to fire backwards once in a while.
What happens then?
Run.
Run.
You stand still and wait to see where it's going to land. You start running, that's not good. You wait to see where it is and then move over a couple feet.
Is that because you don't like running?
How do you think you became Fat Jimmy?